Today's Wire Wrap is brought to you by Advance Title Service, who welcomes Heather Powell Baxter. They'll come to you if you need any title work done. It's Uptown Service with a down-home touch. First thing Saturday from 7 to 9, fans, teams, and coaches will be at the courthouse to see who's going to play who, so join them. The Leadership Cannon Bunch will meet at the Lions Club building this morning. The Flea Market will be handing out candy Saturday morning. Also, the First Baptist Church will be having hot dogs from 5 to 8 p.m. Leanne's Horses and Camps Broken Hearts is holding Spooktoberfest, which will be a car show concert by J.C. Anderson and more. Starts at 10 a.m. and goes until 8 p.m. at the fairgrounds. Border Wars continues. Kittrell versus Warren County and Girls Action at 10. Woodbury Grammar School versus Westside Boys at 11:15. Middle Tennessee Christian versus Westside Girls in the championship at 12:30. And Auburn versus Kittrell Boys in the championship starting at 1:45. Football boosters will have their haunted house still going on at the Veterans Memorial Gym on Lehman Street. Mooretown VFD will be handing candy out tonight at the firehall from 5 to 9:30. College Street and Lehman Street will be closed tonight and the curfew in Woodbury is 10 p.m. 5:30 to 7, Pleasant View Baptist will be having a trunk or treat. The Woodbury Nursing Center will be handing out candy from 5:30 to 8:30, so please stop by. They would really appreciate it. There's also Scarefest on Lonnie Smith Road put on by the Band Boosters. It's actually Haunted Woods from 7 to 10. One more Halloween party tonight at the Community Center from 8 to 1 a.m. They also have permission from the Woodbury PD, but kids have to go straight home tonight at 1 p.m. No exceptions. All the little spooks at Busy Kids would like to thank Woodbury Nursing Center for the Halloween goodies. And then there's the garbage men receiving goodie bags from their two-year-olds. The kids love to watch the truck when it comes. Some of them even call Perry Stone and the guy's daddy. Several were festive Friday. First National Bank was one of them.
Happy Halloween from First National Bank.
Then over at Regions Bank, everyone was dressed up as characters from The Wizard of Oz.
Happy Halloween from Regions Bank!
Then at approximately 11:46 a.m., that was Friday, Auburn Town Gasaway and Woodbury Volunteer Fire Departments were called to the scene of a fire on Hurricane Creek Road near Wilson Hollow Road. It was reported that there was a car on fire behind a house. When firefighters arrived, the car appeared to have caught an older log structure on fire, then an RV caught on fire that was between the house and the structure. Neighbors who happened by called the fire in. It was thought that no one was living in the home. A neighbor stated that Steve Davis owned the property and did come down on the weekends. According to a firefighter, the late model Nissan son had been carjacked out of Rutherford County. It didn't appear to have been stripped. Also, they went back out again at about 5 o'clock or so and where the fire had caught back up. Then Warren County Middle School was playing the Woodland Lady Warriors last night at Woodbury Grammar School's Border Wars, an invitational basketball tournament. The Warriors defeated Warren by a score of 44-27. Middle Tennessee Christian School defeated Kittrell by a score of 49-44, so the Warriors will face Middle Tennessee Christian at 12:30 p.m. in girls' action. Then last night, the Auburn Knights defeated Woodbury Cubs by a score of 49-35. The Knights will do battle with Kittrell Saturday at 1:45, and the Consolation Boys game will be today at 11:15 between Woodbury Cubs and Westside. The Lions football team and Boosters Haunted House made their appearance at the game. The Haunted House will continue tonight. Remember, Lehman and College will be closed, so park at the Woodbury Grammar parking lot and walk around to the Haunted House. Remember that daylight savings time ends, and be sure to not only change your clocks, but remember, fall back. Change that little 9-volt battery in your smoke detector. This is Cannonwire reporting from Woodbury, Tennessee with today's Wire Wrap.